I've come to the sad realization. Under these circumstances, I can't do it. I want to be fair. To the guy or to me. Unless it's a situation like in Silver Linings Playbook, where it's all out in the open. I mean, those two individuals knew. They knew up front. You know, she's crazy, he's crazy, you know, quote unquote. They pursued a relationship with the knowledge of, you know, I can't do this game. I can't do it. Thought I could. Love, you know, the ego boosting messages I sometimes get. I can't do it. And the circumstance, I can't. Domestic violence, murder, they shelter, and then subsequent domestic violence. So. Transitional housing. I didn't just learn about all the things you shouldn't do when you're, you know, a previous, you know, when you've been a domestic violence victim, survivor, whatever, when it comes to new people that you get involved with. I didn't just learn about that. I also got a first-hand lesson, learned the hard way, that just because people are in those places and you think you're all in the same boat or whatever, not gonna necessarily treat you with kindness or whatnot. I was naive. I thought, how can a domestic violence victim possibly treat me badly? Unless I'm treating that person badly, which I was doing just the opposite. I'm sorry, but if you are just not treating me good at all, and I'm brand new in there, and I've just been through hell, and I'm under a lot of trauma and whatnot, and I'm being as nice as I can to you, well, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna fall back on you don't like me because of my looks or something. You're jealous or whatnot, because if I'm being nice to somebody and they just don't like me and are outright whatever to me, then if they're not that attractive, then yeah, I'm gonna think it's because they don't like me because of the way I look. I was naive. Everyone in there would be treating everybody with kindness just because, and the fact of the matter is, what does it tell you that there's just one person in the domestic violence emergency shelter and one person in the subsequent, you know, the transitional housing I stayed in afterwards that didn't like me, and the rest I got along fine with? So I'm sorry, but think I'm arrogant, or if you're gonna laugh at me because some of you think I'm ugly. Well, whatever. A lot of people beg to differ on both genders, okay? I really don't care. I know there are certain people who just don't like me because of my looks, you know? And I definitely believe that was the case in those places, because I didn't do anything to warrant the way those two women Well, just the best we can. But in the emergency domestic violence, another woman came later, at a later date. And I was saying to her, why is this woman? And then she goes, well, look at her. Did you see her? You know, she does stuff to herself. And she's like, you can't expect people. Other people are people. And just because you're all in the same boat doesn't mean everyone's going to have the same degree of compassion. I'm like, well, yeah. I guess I learned that, didn't I? And then I went on to learn it even more in the fucking transitional housing. Just trauma, double trauma. And Laura just spends every day wondering when she's gonna just go see me. Here than in the shelter, but the pain from when I was a kid is coming back, and it all centers around the fact that my aunt, the power of my mother just looms over us, you know, just like fuck the afraid, just always there. Really might have to pick up a drink one of these days. Can't date. Not when I'm going through this, you know? Everything be going fine, and then something happens, like what happened 2 weeks ago with Matt Marion, you know? And then I'm just like, this is ridiculous. Who am I kidding? It's not fair to the guy. I only want to go out on a date. I'm not looking for a relationship. I just want to go on one date. I just want to, you know, like I said, just prove that I can do it and sit across from someone and flirt and know that that person desires me, you know? But another snafu that sometimes happens in these dating website things is you think you're attracted to the person, and then they don't look like their picture, or maybe they uploaded a picture from before they'd gained 20 pounds or something, you know. I just don't know when you meet someone in person. I'll never, ever forget one of the worst nights of my life. It was so just awful. I'd been making gaga eyes, flirting over the phone with this guy for a long time. We had each other's pictures. We both thought we were attracted. I thought I was attracted to him. He was attracted to me. We met, and I just instantly hadn't realized how skinny he was. Or, you know, because I was a big girl. I would have been a big girl. He's just scrawny, and I wasn't attracted to him at all. Oh, and all the men. Now, me being me, if he, you know, had felt. He later said, no, he was too small in my eyes, I was too big, but if he had made me feel comfortable or something, then maybe it wouldn't have mattered, but it was instant, no, not comfortable, and on the phone we had flirted and this, that, or whatever, and oh my god, it was horrible meeting. neither of us had lied. We had just tricked her. We had each tricked ourselves into believing it was more than it was. And later, my cousin said to me, well, couldn't you have grown to be attracted to each other? Or couldn't you have grown to be attracted to him? And I'm like, no, not under the circumstances, because it was too awkward. It's horrible. When you go out on these dates with these dating websites and Craigslist and whatnot, and if that person is very attracted to you and you're not attracted to that person, it's just awkward. And I know it's life and I have to be mature, but I can't do it. Not when my life is just total chaotic right now and whatnot. I'm concerned under the circumstances. The guys I may or may not write to and let down easy, you know. I'm doing them a favor. They're not going to understand or think so. I wouldn't be under anywhere near the same kind of pressure as I am when someone from a dating website thinks that I really like him and I know what he looks like and I've chosen him or whatnot. And there's just no chemistry, there's nothing. It's happened to me on more than one occasion. It just sucks. I'm just an immature little girl and I can't deal with any of this. Not unless it's like in Summer Linings Playbook, where it was just casual, where they both knew who the other was, you know? They're gonna get to know each other, but at least they know up front the important shit. So they know that they're both crazy. I feel like it's just been... As I so eloquently put it in that song I wrote like 12 years ago, 13 years ago. Running from my own.